Start.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Welcome to our viewers in India and abroad, and a happy Diwali. Today's session is going to be our 13th cultural heritage series, and today's prayer is going to be by Gaurav. Gaurav is a plus one student at Chettinad Vidyashram in MRC Nagar, Chennai. And besides, it's plus one ongoing online classes. He is a student of music, both vocal and violin, and he's a student of Parur Dr. Harini Sivatsa, already known to us. Gaurav is also into Vedas, a student of Vedas, and also in yoga classes. I'm proud that Gaurav is my batchmate in our yoga classes. Gaurav is also into martial arts, learning Kallari, a form of martial arts called Silambam. We are very happy and proud to welcome Gaurav for our prayer song. Over to you, Gaurav.
कारणपद चित्रूप कांचीपुर सीमने कामपीठगता काचन विहरति करुणा काश्मीरस्तपक कंचन कांची निलयम् करद्रित कोदंड बाणश्रेणिपाशम् कठिनस्तनभरणम् रम् कैवल्यानन्दकन्दम् अवलम्बे
Thank you, Gaurav. We hope to see you again in our ongoing series in the near future. Now, as I mentioned, today's session is 13th in our series and our ongoing cultural heritage awareness on Kashmir. As always, we thank Sri Kanchi Mutt for this initiative and offer our namaskarams to Sri Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigal and for his blessings. Today's session is going to be by Hari Krishan Siddha, and the topic is Marthanda Mahatmyam, birthplace of 13th Sangha Marthanda in Kashmir. Today's session is also 13th in our series. See, Hari Krishan Siddha's short bio: a teacher by profession and principal of Shastri Memorial Higher Secondary School, Patoli in Jammu. He got his B.E.D. from Jammu University. Hari Krishan Siddha is fluent in 5 languages: Kashmiri, Urdu, Hindi, Sanskrit, and English. He also learned ancient script, Sharda. He has written books in Sharda script for its revival. He is a very resourceful person. His books on different topics covering religious places of Kashmir in all the above languages that I mentioned. Also composed poems, bhajans, harti, and slokas. See, Kanchi Mutt has been in the forefront, modestly working with the sole aim of national integration, spiritual enlightenment, and spreading the uniqueness as Kashmir is our cultural heritage. We thank all our speakers participating in this ongoing series, and we now request Sri Hari Krishan Siddha to take over. His lecture is going to be with lots of visuals and photographs. As he speaks, I'll be projecting all the photographs and the slides. And after the session is over, we also have a short session on photographs. Over to you, sir.
Namaskaram to Kanchi, Kamakoti Peetham, Srimatam Sanastam, Koti Koti Pranamam to Most Venerable Shankaracharyaji, respectable scholars, intellectuals, followers of Sanastan, and all the viewers. Last but not least, Shri V. Shankarji, who is organizer of this series. I feel honored to be the part of this 13th awareness series of Kashmir Cultural Heritage organized by Madhyama Dharma Samajam and Kanchi Koti Seva Foundation. Before proceeding further to my topic, I pray to my deities, Mahamartanda Kashmira, Namaste Sharada Devi, Kashmir Purvasani, Tamaham Prarthe Nityam, Vidya Jnanam Cha Dehi Me, Brahmasarupa Parama Jyotir, Jyotirupa Sanatano, Sarvavidya Deviya, Tasyavaniye Namo Nama, Basuti Bhima Bhargashika Bhavani Bhagavati, Vimal Kamal Gautam Nagarajaye, Ganga Nand Bhairavaye, Chakrasute Chaka Bhagavati, Sahasrarashme Vidmahe, Bhaskaraye Dhimahe, Tanno Suryo Prachodayat, Adi Devay Vidmahe, Mahamartanataay Dhimahe, Tanno Suryo Prachodayat, Basat Punjkaram Prasad Vadanam, Pitambaram Alankritam, Padmam Cha Abai Pustak Japavati, Hasterya Dadanam Prabhu, Sarvata Agni Samhan Kanti Amalam, Netro Triyo Basitam, Deva Bi Parivaritam Cha Vardam, Maham Artanatham Namah, Nama Vishnu Bhavanam, Namo Sargadharam, Nama Shakti Pite, Namo Bhargarupam, Tamev Siddhi Lakshmi, Tam Chakrapani, Aham Tam Sharanam, Rachyamam Bhavani, Shilarup Devi Velao Rajpataka, Sitthim Shikhare Pretyaksha Rupa, Martadnathasya Tam Chakshu Jyoti, Shat Shat Pranamam Nama Koti Koti, Martadnathasya Tam Rajarani, Aham Tam Sharanam Rakshumam Bhavani. Kashmir, a paradise on earth, a garden of eternal springs, a delightful flower of different colors, and a heart-expanding heritage of saints, rishis, and devrishis. All India has attained an appellation of being the land of spiritualism, but Kashmir has been described as the valley of saints, rishis, and Dev Rishis. Almost all the shrines of Kashmir are named after incarnation, gods, goddesses, saints, and sages. It is home of ancient shrines. So it is considered as holy land. There are 45 Shiva Dhams, 60 Vishnu Dhams, 22 Shakti Dhams, 700 Nag Dhams, and thousands of Devas.
Looks like Hare Krishna Siddha has some issues. Connectivity is presenting from Jammu, and we will work on that. Oh, he's back.
Yeah. There are thousands of devadas. Pilgrims throng to these shrines in big numbers. As far Mahatmyas are concerned, there are Mahatmyas, that is the work glorifying the sacred places, containing legends about them to prove how they are favored by gods and bring religious merit to the devotees. These works show importance of giving geographical information and throwing light of religious practices. The Mahatmyas are the first place or guidebooks which give the merit, which supports the pandits, brahmans, purohits to do the work according to these Mahatmyas. They show the routes taken by the devotees. Now, as per Martin Mahatmya is concerned, Brahmaji, the creator, who is creator of mobile and immobile, animate and inanimate, wanted to locate a sacred place on the earth. So he wanted to discuss it with Bhagavan Vishnu and Maheshwara. Because Kali Yuga was going to be coming in, so they located a place on the earth. Tapovartam jagadishane punyasaranam samadisha praya kaliyugo yatra na samanami bhavishyati yatra patkino yate krite sadham vimuktaye pratham tasya kshetrasya darpalo vyavistata अनंत नाग नामाक्षो शयाभूत मनीषरा अनंतस्य प्रेमस्य विष्णु रमित तेजसा अनेक्षा पुरी प्रप्रह शेषनागो महाबली वस्तसा च सदा लोकान पावनार्थ दिजर शवा. They decided to find out a holy place where Kaliyuga will have no effect. The sons of Vishwakarma were sent, Bhavana and Bhushana. They located a place on the earth and they named it as Bhavan. Shetra namutvam shetram ast Kashmir mandalam tatra asti suri shetram martandam nam vasati trailokye bhutalam saram tatra pihim vatgiri तत्रापि मंडतम तीर्थे पुण्यम कश्मीर मंडले मार्तंड नाम तीर्थस्य एतत् एकं विशेषता येषां दर्शन मात्रेन सदा पाप क्षयो भवेत्. दिस मार्तंड विच वॉज नेम्ड एज द भवन, इट वॉज कंसिडर्ड टू बी दैट प्लेस. On the darshan of this, only on seeing this, only on visiting this place, one could be get salvation of, yeah, he will be get out of these sins. It was said that in Kali Yuga, those people who do the evil deeds, they will be considered as dead. Only those persons who do the right things, who do the good things, who are righteous, who are kind, they are the living people. Now, as far Martanda was concerned, it is Punnivishno Bhavaneshradam. Dude, in these Mahatmyas, there is conversation only. There were many, as many shrines, there were Mahatmyas. But unfortunately, with the passage of time, but unfortunately, due to the dark ages of the Kashmir, they were all vanished. They were buried. They were burnt. And this time, if we see, we hardly find some of the Mahatmyas. There are only few, 16 to 20, which are in Dogra library. There are only few in Sanskrit library of this Jammu. This shows that we have been out of these Mahatmyas. Hardly we get some, and there are some differences. We find differences in them. I found some Mahatmyas, Martand Mahatmyas. The story lies there, but with some difference. We are grateful to some intellectuals like Yashpal Khujuria ji, Dr. Ved Gai ji, who made us available these Mahatmyas. Otherwise, we were without these Mahatmyas. In Bringesh Samhita, there are two types of Mahatmyas of Martanda. In one, there is story with more than 233 shlokas, and other is 16 page only, and with shows the only the importance, significance of Martanda. Now, as for this Punya Vishnu Bhavane Shradam Kritva Maheshari Pitra Tripti Mayanti Kalpanam Shatam Antata Vishnu Bhavane Datva Tilamatra Maheshari मेरु तुल्यं भवेत् च देवी सत्यं वदामिते मत्सभवने पुण्यं कृतं मेरु समं भवेत् तत्र सनात्वा सदा देवी वाजपेय फलं लभेत्. इन दीज शलूकास, दीज आर शलूकास फ्रॉम डिफरेंट महात्म्यास. इन वन इट मेंशंस भवने, इन सेकंड इट मेंशंस विष्णु भवने, in third, it says Matsubhavane. In fourth, it says Matsubhavane. This shows the change of nomenclature of Mahartanda Bhavana. It had changed from time to time. With the passage of time, in Vedantic Yuga, in Puranic Yuga, it has changed its name. Its name was Bhavana. Then it was called Matsubhavana. Then it was called Matsubhavana. Then it was called Martanda. Then it was called Matan. 5-6 times it has changed. But still, the corrects of this Bhavana, Martanda Tirtha, is same as it was in the Vedic period. As it was, it had in the beginning. Martanda Shrine is of great religious significance, not only for Kashmiri Pandits, but it acts just like the Setu, just like the bridge between India and Kashmir. From the very beginning, when there were some shortcomings due to the geographical point of view. Settle people from India used to come here. People settle from the northern plains, the people used to come here for ablation of their disease burns. For salivation, it is called as to be the Mokshadara. It is called to be the Swargadara. It is called because only by seeing, by visiting this place, one can get the punya of donating a cow. It is written, it is mentioned in these Mahatmyas. Martanda, as you know, everybody knows, Mrit Anda Martanda, it came from the impotent egg. Aditya, which has 12 sons, this 13th one, Martanda, who had come to finish, kill all the Dityas, Danavas, Pishachas. This Kashmir, when it was formed, Pishachas, Nagas, and Vanshas used to live there. Nagas prohibited to live with the Vanshas. At that time, Kashyap Rishi cursed them. Go and live with Pishachas. It is said that for some time, for many years, for hundreds and hundreds of years, people of this valley had to go out of valley for 6 months. They used to come to valley after 6 months in the Vaishak, Chaitra Shukla Paksh, Pratipadam. They used to come back. But Neel Naga showed the way. He gave us some rituals. He gave some traditions. He gave some customs to Chandradeva, who by chance was not able to go out of the valley when in Kartik Purnamami, Purnamasi, everyone was going out of the valley. Neel Naga found him. He told him that one can stay in Kashmir, one can stay in valley if he will follow certain rules, regulations, traditions, customs, rites, and those rites we were using from time to time. But unfortunately, when we seize these traditions, when we seize those customs, we are displaced from that valley. It is curse given by Kashyap Rishi and Pishachas. Pishachas are there always. Shri Krishna, Lord Krishna, when he came there for Raja Abhishek of Yashomati, he had said, Kashmira Parvati Raja Geyo Haram Shija. Nav Geyo Sa Dushto Api Vidusha Bhutam Ichchata. He had given the indication that there would be some people, there would be some emperors, there would be some rulers who will be cruel. But we have always to show their faith, respect, reverence to them. Because this land is Sati Parvati itself, and its emperor is always Lord Shiva. This time, now after getting birth, Martanda was giving the portfolio. He became the proprietor of Adhikmasa, Malmasa, Banamasa. Because it is here Martanda, if we will see that democracy had its roots from Martanda. When Martanda got the birth, Kashyap Rishi asked Brahmaji what portfolio we should give him. Brahmaji told that let them do themselves, let them decide themselves. Here is the first stage of democracy. He had given the time to them to discuss, to elect. Election was done. What kind of portfolio should be given to Marthanda? And he became, because Kalachakra was already in the hands of his brothers, 12 brothers. After Brahma Siddhartha, they find that after 32 months, 16 days and 24 minutes, they can get one Adhikmasa, and that was given to Marthanda. Marthanda became the head proprietor of that. And Marthanda became the Swargadar, Mokshadar. Sananam Danam Japohoma Swadai Surachita Krito Bhavani Puraksha Ananto Bhavedbhuvam Angye Vyova Sati Nama. When he, Marthanda, opened his eyes, there came the flames. He himself is called the luminous god, 13th representative of sun god. And that flame that is still called the Bhargashika, which fly over and reside on the top of the mountain of Marthanda. Bhargashika, top of the mountain, and it is a part of that jyoti. There were four jyotis which came out when he opened his eyes from his hriday. Vasati came out, which also remained there. Bhavani, Bhima Bhagavati, and these four flames, these four deities, they remain in the east, west, north, and south, and they reside there. And settle, there are two of them. We can find them, and Vasuti and Bhavani. The temples of Vasuti and Bhavani, they were destroyed, they were demolished during the Khan period, during the Aurangzeb period. And now there are Bhima Bhagavati and Bhargashika Bhagavati. Now, as for Marthan Mahatmya, it shows the quality, it shows the luminous god. Marthanda, he was given the power for the salvation. Any person, anyone who does not get moksha anywhere in the world, he can get moksha from Marthanda. It is said that Marthanda destroyed the Dityas and Danavas. Rishis from Uttarakhand came once, approached Marthanda, prayed him. And Marthanda, being pleased, asked them what they want. They said that they are worrying, they are tired of the worrying world, have come for help because Rakshas teased them. He was red with anger, and yoginis came out, thousands of yoginis came out of his nostrils. And these yoginis attacked the Yakshas, the Danavas, and Padastal is the place, Lokari is the place where they struggled, where there was battle between yoginis and Pishachas. Pishachas were killed, and yoginis were commanded, they were directed to sit in Marthand, and the fish found in the Kamal and Vimal. There are two springs, Kamal and Vimal, and they lie there. They follow the visitors. They are those yoginis which are in form of fish. Every time when there is some dispute, when there is anything happening, the color of the water changes. The fish go underground they are not seen. Martin Martin is one of the many granthas that throws light on the importance and significance of Martha Shrine. The main importance is to have prayashchit, or for evil deeds done anywhere in Marthand and at any city. According to Marthand Mahatmya, all evil doers shall be considered as dead. Prayena prajineshanti eti evana samshaya pramadinoho vrita yasman jivantastu pramadina papinastu vrita prokta punya jivanti evahi jivatancha vrite vancha deveti nischalam sananam danam tapohoma japaswadhai vacha tadsheve bhave devi na atra me asti vicharana mrityu udaran dakshaya garbo udaran hetve tejasam ketve tubhyam hetve jagtve jagta am api. Anyone who baths there, who goes there, who had some religious deeds there, he is free from any kind of incident, accident. One who baths there, perform worship, shraddha, austries, get the same fruit of imperishable as he gets in Prayaga, in Gaya, in Ganga, Haridwar, in Kurukshetra. In the month of Adhikmasa, Malamasa, Banamasa, he becomes very powerful. Marthanda, during those days, it is considered to be the Swargadar, door of the heaven. Even one who offers pindadan, tarpan, offer honey, milk, ghee, darb, and things of his desire, especially during the Malamas and Banamas, satisfy his diseased ones. Even the worship of Marthanda with devotion is enough to get salvation and gain the fruit of giving 100 cows in charity. This shows that Marthanda, there we can get any kind of fruit by visiting there, by having tarpan, by having sankala, by having charity, by having donation, by having anything, by having darshan only, that can give us too much things. Tatastilodakam, there are some rules, there are some policies, there are some these celebrations which one has to do there. Especially there is Dashpindi. Tatastilodakam Devat Brita Vasuk Vishnave Sarva Papa Nevertam Vishnu Padastu Yesuta Tato Dadyat Pretnena Dashpinda Vidanata Pretai Pratmam Yamaya Vyapne Arpayet Dutiyam Vasudevaya Dharmarajaya Apitata Narayanay Trutiyam Nasede Mrityu Vyapne Shivaitu Chaturtham Chaiva Sutta Vyapne Arpayet Yamaya Panchakam Kalapash Vyapak Dharmane Shishtam Pindam Bhavayata Chatak Vyapne Nasede Saptamam Atyadi Rupai Sarva Prana Harai Cha Ashtamam Yom Rupai Parameshit Sarupini Naumam Brahmane Pinnam Chitra Gupta Atmakai Cha Iti Vishnu Kriyai Astu Dash Pindarpani Vidi Tilashiran Vitan Darda Tilahan Karpurkan Dakshinabhimukhe Vishnu Dhyatavakshipet Jalantare Pindam Dadatva Anjalina Dadat Kumbam Tutgil Mishratam Yamartan. One can do Sukhsanan, Sukhsanan, and Shoksanan, Shoksradam. There are every type of possibilities, and accidents, khaya, or those who have not been found by through accidents or through any type of death, they can get benefited from Martan. Many religious kriyas can be done according to one's capability and status. The kriyas which can be performed there, they are tarpan. Anyone who has no time, who visits there for few minutes, he can do the tarpan. There are sankalap, there are shraad, there are daan, there are prayachit, there are jap, tap, hom, yaj, pindadan, dashpindi, surya bali, narayan bali, as per the devotee's wish. Because patram pushpam phalam toyam, it is the best way that you can get the salvation, you can get out of your sins. You can be free from sins only by visiting such types of shrines. By donating, by prayachit. Because when our heart, which is ready to have a prayachit for any kind of sin, we can get salvation from this shrine. There are some significance. There are some, I may say, some people who were benefited. For example, Shri Parshuramaji. He came Martanda. He did his penance at Martanda Shrine. And purify himself from the sins of natricide. He did the prayachit in Martanda. There was so many incidents. Raja Ramadev from Gujarat, he left his kingdom and stayed in Martam Shrine. He wished to die at the feet of Martanda. He did the same. He remained in Martanda till the last breath of his life. Kalsh, Raja Kalsh, father of Harshvardhana, he also wished to die at the feet of Martanda. It is written, it is mentioned in the Rajtinagni that he called his mantris, ministers to take him to Martanda. Whereas he was those days in Vijayeshwara. Vijayeshwara was considered to be the most sacred place of Kashmir. But he preferred to go to Martanda. He went to Martanda and there he was shown the image. He could not go in the temple. He could not go upside. At the gate, he signed with his gesture. He showed his minister to show him the image of Martandanatha. He was shown the image of Martandanatha through a mirror, and he breath is lost after having the darshan of Martandanatha. His wife, she donated the golden murti of Martandanatha there, because Kalsha, Raja Kalsh, he had disrespected that murti once, and at his last moment, he remembered that scene. So he ordered to die at Martanda. All the kriyas were done. They stayed for the whole year, and they did all the kriyas there in Martanda. There is Gautam. Gautam Naga is there. Is this Anantanag is considered to be as the Dharapal of Martanda. Anantanaga is considered to be as the Dwarpala of this Martanda. Yatra patika naho yate krite sadam vimuktaye pratyumtai siketrasye dharapalo vivistata. God has given the chance to Sheshnaga to sit at the Dwarpal, at the gate of Martanda. And Anantanaga is called the gateway to Martanda. Anantanaga Nagaksho Shayabhuta Manishara Anantaisya Premasya Vishnu Ramitejasa Anikshapure Vipra Sheshnago Mahavali Vastichasadalokan Pavanartha Dijarshaba. So this shows the importance of Martanda. Lord Indra came there for the prayashchit. Because he was cursed by Gautama Rishiji. In this Surya Kshetra, we can see so many miracles. So many kings, emperors, they came there. They bow their heads before the Martanda. They bow there. There are several pattas, written pattas were available there. Nowadays they are not, but I have translation of some pattas with me. I have kept them. Aurangzeba, Akbar, Todarmal, Bihari Chand, and all the kings of northern India. Because this India was having the 560 states, and the Maharajas from Punjab, from UP, from Delhi, from Madhya Pradesh, they used to visit this shrine often. It is said, Dhanamukto yata suryo rahu muktaish chandrama tatha papi nirvokta sradhakartana samshaya meratulli kritam papam vishnu sradhe vishishete putrava bratro vapi dahitra putrakas tatha vishnu sradhesya kartaraste yati paramam gatim idam martand mahatmyam vishnu sradham samanvitam. Anyone can do srad to anyone. It is not necessary that only the sons, brothers, children, sisters, children, all, anyone can do these Shraddhas to anyone. Merutulyam kratam papam. Oh, here they have mentioned that mountain to a mole. If the evil deeds are about a mountain, that means a large number, it can become the mole. While performing worship in Martanda. Anishetri ekritam papam Martan shekhte vinishyate Suri shetri ekritam papam Vajralepam nashudyate. But there is warning. There is advice. There is appeal. It is directed that anyone, any evil deed, any sin that is done outside Martan Kshetra, outside Suri Kshetra, there were 52 Kshetras in Kashmir. And in South Kashmir, that is in Anantanag district, this time this is called the Anantanag district, it has 16 Kshetras. शिव पार क्षेत्र, पद्म क्षेत्र, भवानी क्षेत्र, लक्ष्मी क्षेत्र, मुक्ति क्षेत्र, सिद्ध क्षेत्र, बुद्धि क्षेत्र, वृद्धि क्षेत्र, विष्णु क्षेत्र, ब्रह्म क्षेत्र, सूर्य क्षेत्र, नारायण क्षेत्र एंड गणपति क्षेत्र. दीज वर 16 क्षेत्र. एंड इन सूर्य क्षेत्र एनी एवर एनी मिसडीड डन कैन नेवर बी गेट बेनिफिट. He will have to face evil deeds, cannot be benefited here. Only those people who come from another place. श्रीमार्तंड शुभे क्षेत्रे सप्तम्याम चोर विदिने विजयानाम स प्रोक्ता पितरन आमी मुक्तये. श्रीमार्तंड, there are certain festivals, there are certain days, especially when there is Vijay Saptami, when there is eclipse, when there is Malamasa, when there is Banamasa, during these days, during these festivals, one is benefited more as compared to normal days. Lord Vishnu blessed this month, that is Malamasa. He remarked that all the devotional performance will yield great result. Lord Krishna is worshipped during this month. The existence of fasting and praying is done during this month. In most states of India, it is called Parshottama Masa. But during this month, no shrine except Ganga, Gaya, Prayag and Marathon should be used. Only oblation to ancestors, Surya Bali, Vishnu Bali and charity for the sake of emancipation of sinners is done here. And the best place to perform these rituals is Suri Kshetra or Marathanda. A combination of Sunday, Shravan Nakshatra, Kar Yoga. This yoga makes the Vijay Saptami. Saints, rishis, they used to pray for this month, pray for this day. But during Kali Yuga, we can find this Vijaya Saptami once every year. This shows the capability for the emancipation of our sin, for the oblation of our diseases ones. God has given us the chance. We should perform these activities in Marathanda, and one should be benefited by it. They get satisfied if they come out of the clouds into bright sunlight. Because it is said that they always wait there for the Shraddha at Marathan Kshetra. Worship to Lord Marathanda is equal to Vishnu Bali. It is said in the Marathan Mahatmya, Bhairava says to Bhairavi, because Marthandanam Tastketram Pitranam Mukti Karakam Chakreshwari Savad Gautam Sangme. Anyone who does the work, who does perform the worship at Shaka Nadi, at Sangam, Gautam Sangme, Chakreshwari Samarambe Yavad Gautam Sangame Marathan Kshetram Tat Kshetram Petranam Mukti Kartam. One who does the performs these shrads at Sangam, their ancestors will get salvation definitely. All Kashmiri points, they are source of Brahmans. We follow the Logesh Rishi's Padati. All religions and social activities are same as shown us to that by these rishis. We follow them. These are the, as mentioned in the Nilavat Puran, we always recall our ancestors during the morning. We give the tarpan because we always want to be connected to our roots. The main philosophy behind it is only to have to never to forget our ancestors, to be in touch with our roots, and we Kashmiri poets, although we have been displaced 7 times, but still we think that blessings of our ancestors, blessings of these shrines have always been with us, because we always do the best. We are God-fearing people. We are peace-loving people. And we are always benefited wherever we go. Even if we are displaced, but still, we are satisfied that we worshipped our God. And this is the best way. Because we worshipped our God and we have our Thakurji. We always pray to 5 gods, that is to Ganesha, Lord Vishnu, Lord Shiv, and Shakti, always. We always pray these lords. Now, I have also been given the directive to talk about the Martha temple. This was the Martha shrine. Now, there is one more place near Martha. It is 2 kilometers from Martha, that is Martha temple. Martha temple that was built, that was constructed by a great king of Kashmir, Lalitaditya Muktapi. Lalitaditya, he ruled Kashmir for 38 years, from 724 to 761 AD. His period is known to be the glorious period in the history of Kashmir, because he is considered to be great builder of many famous towns and temples. Many towns were built by him. Many temples were built by him. It is not possible to trace all the sites because we have faced so many termites. We have faced so many cruel kings, dark ages. During his reign, his kingdom, he expanded his kingdom from Kamboj to Kanauj. He handed over the charge of western part to Ratta Rani, the great king. Lalitaditya, he was the person who brought the intellectuals, scholars from UP and other states of India to Kashmir, because there was a time when we needed some scholars, and he was the person. He had built the buildings, the structures. He constructed, that is the glorious piece of architect of Hindu kings. Deliberately, the fundamentalists destroyed and demolished such temples, such buildings. For example, Martan temple, which can beat the many wonders, many buildings of the world. Even Taj is nothing before it. This time it is in ruins, but still it is more glorious, more beautiful than anything. It is the architect behind it is much more. It is 2,220 feet by 142 feet. It had 84 columns, 6 by 8 feet high. The height of this building It was 75 feet to 80 feet. The surrounding of this so marvelous that even today one wonders how these high, very large stones have been taken from one place to another, because during these days when it is in ruins, the stones which have fell down, they remain there, nobody could lift them. There were mattas, there were several earthen pots, there were many other things which were marvelous there. But with the passage of time, we lost them all. The mandap, which was in the center, the temple which was in the center, that was 63 by 36 feet. There was a golden statue in it. It is said there was a diamond on the top of this temple. The light of this diamond was seen from Brijeshwara. But it was destroyed by cruel kings. It is said that wood was collected in it for 1 year and then it was burned. And this was the cause of its demolition and destruction. There was a Gurukul in this Marathon temple. There were saints, there were rishis, there were so many religious people who used to give education to so many students. It was a very golden period during those days when it was there, and there had been a protest. When Bhutsikan came there was a protest. It is said thousands of saints, the rishis, they stood against him. And instead of now demolishing the temples and making the mosques, the Bhutsikan changed his policy. They started killing the pandits. Thus, in this way, this was burned, this was demolished, this was destroyed, and people started fleeing from this piece of land, or this Swargalok, that is paradise, which is called the paradise Kashmir. Thank you. Jai Marathon, Jai Marathon.
Thank you, Sri Hari Krishan. Before I make the concluding remarks, I thought we'll take our viewers to various photographs that was taken very recently, and then I'll make my concluding remarks. Just a few minutes. These are all the photographs taken in 2012 on all the places that we talked about, Marthand Teet, and this one is, as you can see, Marthand Teet. That's about the temple. I'll just quickly go through this. This is about the temple. The description given based on what we probably covered most of them. We will see mostly the photograph. This is the entrance to the famous temple that he is talking about. When you visit this site, we guarantee that you will have tears. You'll be shedding, especially those who have seen big temple in Tanjore that we are used to. The grandeur of this temple is almost equivalent to what we are seeing in the south. This is the main entrance. As you could see, there are deities there. And we could only feel a little bit of what should have been there. See, this is another deity that we are very accustomed to seeing in the temple praharams. This is a closer look. So the amount of destruction you can imagine, what would have happened to all the pillars and the courtyard and you were talking about. This is the temple Praharam that we are so used to seeing in South India, in most of the temples. Look at the condition of this. As we are seeing from all these Kashmir lectures, it is not just talking about the past glory of Kashmir. It is about the meaningful, the value system and the meaningful culture that existed. And unfortunately, in the last 2,000 years, it's been lost and we're trying to revive. As you mentioned, displaced several times and then destroyed many times. See the temple? This is one of those entrances, the sides and all. Some of these are still intact. You could see that. Probably they could not destroy them. This is another deity that is very common in our temples. This is from another side of the temple. Everything that you see is all in ruins, all destroyed. This must have been on the other rear side. These are all the this is what we have seen so far. As he explained, it's a meaningful culture of Kashmir, not just a past glory. He also talked about the rituals. It's no longer called rituals, like we have seen in the earlier lectures by some of our scholars. He mentioned that these are dharmic practices. That is what he highlighted. And we are so used to Kashmir, Varanasi, Gaya, and Prayag. We go there for pilgrimage, starting from Rameshwaram. We are so used to. And only when you visit these places, you know the significance of that. I feel Kashmir must have been left out. Every dharmic practices he was talking about existed in Kashmir. And hopefully, there is going to be a revival, and it is going to be a going to be on the pilgrim map shortly. So we would continue the pilgrimage when you go to Kashi. I don't know whether these facilities exist right now in Kashmir, and it's about time it gets started. You also mentioned that just by visiting the temple and by seeing it, one gets salvation or moksha. That is similar to what we talk about our temples. We are so used to seeing in place like Tiruvannamalai, that is widely talked about in South India. So there are a lot of similarities that you talked about in dharmic practices, in the culture, and he talked about the policies, the celebration. He mentioned about democracy, following rules. Hopefully, your displacement you mentioned would be the last one. And you will all return one day and continue the past glory that existed long ago. Once again, I want to thank you on our viewers, on behalf of all our viewers, for the time you took to prepare and shared all the details with us. We look forward to seeing you again. And we also want to thank our associates, starting from VDSP, then Kamakodi TV, Kamakodi Facebook, and YouTube channels, and we'll also be streaming in few other television channels soon. Thank you, sir. And we look forward to seeing you again next Saturday, same time.